My name is Jake, and this is my deconversion story. I've been an atheist for almost 3 years now. Before that, I was a Christian for the first 21 years of my life or so. And ever since I can remember, I've been involved in church, going to church, doing church-related activities. My parents raised my two brothers and I within the Assemblies of God, kind of Pentecostal denomination for most of our lives. We attended the same church for about a decade. We went to private Christian school pretty much exclusively through our elementary school years. And that was kind of where I really got a lot of the ideas about like creationism and that kind of thing. And after elementary school, my parents pulled me out and started homeschooling us. That's kind of when I started to find out a lot more about what a lot of the more fundamentalist Christians believe and what they practice. Like, we would go to these homeschool conventions, you know, the ones where I have 15 passenger vans full of kids and, you know, all the denim skirts and all the combed back hair and tucked in shirts. That was kind of my homeschooling experience for a lot of my middle school and high school years. So that was interesting, but I guess I didn't really object or anything. It was, as far as I could tell, it was just like a more proper and more correct way of practicing Christianity. So I went along with it, and I thought that was the best way to follow God. You know, ever since I was born, I have always been exposed to Christian ideas, Christian literature in school, Christian teaching, that kind of stuff. I didn't really realize it at the time, but a lot of kind of the structure that I had grown up in was really kind of a bubble. So I never really had a good idea of what it was like to not be a Christian. And I didn't really have a clear view of like what people outside of the church even did or were like, because everything that I saw and that I heard was filtered through my parents and church leaders and stuff. And, you know, everything they told me about what people outside the church were like, that was pretty much what I believed. And that's kind of all my perception and expectation was of people who weren't like us for years. Growing up, I had read the Bible. I had read it multiple times, I think at least three times cover to cover, over the course of my childhood and schooling experience. And, you know, a lot of the explanations and kind of ways that my parents and my pastors would kind of talk about certain verses, some like really problematic stuff. A lot of the ways that they described it, I never really thought twice about it. The first time I really started asking questions and looking around was when my family had kind of a blow up with another family at our church. I kind of stepped back and I was like, this just seems like any other kind of disagreement that people have in or outside of the church. Trying to reconcile these two things that, you know, there's people that don't believe and they're actually really nice. And then seeing people inside of the church, not all of them, obviously, but there are still people that fight and don't get along. And it's not the one big happy family that we all want it to be. But that was kind of the first time that I started asking the question, like, what makes us who we are? Is it religion? Is it something else? What is it? And it was not too long after that when my brother was diagnosed with cancer. That definitely changed my perspective for sure. I didn't really feel like I needed to explain his diagnosis. It just felt like a normal, random, unfortunate thing that happens to anyone. It didn't feel like God was testing us or anything like that. I don't know, I wasn't mad at God or anything. This kind of gave me the perspective that maybe things aren't guided. Maybe things just happen randomly, because I saw good things and bad things happening to both good and bad people. You know, growing up in the church doesn't seem to make you a better person. And it also doesn't seem to have any effect on the kinds of circumstances that happen to you. Obviously, people who believe in God tend to explain and give meanings behind what happens, but you know, if you really look at it, we all kind of go through the same stuff. As the months kept coming and going, my brother's condition started to get worse. And this was kind of where I saw, like, my family and my mom especially take a different path than I did. She started to get really involved in these pseudoscience kind of alternative healing and medicine kind of practices. And obviously it was with good intention. She was trying to help her son, but I just saw her become more extreme with her beliefs and kind of chase anything that would give her hope. And I kind of took a different path. I started thinking a lot more about death and mortality, and I looked into like Stoic philosophy and different things like that. So I was definitely more curious about these other ideas and ways that other people had kind of explained and thought about these common problems that we all go through. But I was definitely still a Christian and I still believed, and I didn't really change much of what I believed until after my brother died in end of 2018. That's when I really started to kind of question what I thought and how I was raised. It's not because I was angry at God or anything. I think at that point, the question started entering my mind, you know, is there really anybody to be mad at? I guess I didn't really have an answer for that. I didn't feel like I was justified in blaming something or someone for what happened to my brother. You know, this kind of stuff happens to everyone, you know, good and bad people, however you define it, you know, religious, non-religious, believing in all sorts of gods. It's just, I don't know, it was just life. So it was about that time that I started to find out more about the Bible that I was raised to believe. I learned a lot about kind of the historical origins and the anonymous authors of so many of the Gospels, and even kind of the way that the books were selected to be added into the Bible. It was all just didn't seem very inspired to me after a while. And so many of these, you know, literal interpretations that I was raised with just didn't hold up anymore. As I started to learn more about science and kind of the way that we actually come to know things, I started to kind of distance myself from those kind of a little bit more fundamental and literal interpretations and parts of the Bible. But I still kind of had the idea in my mind that, you know, Jesus was a real person, and, you know, I still had the whole kind of like, you know, Christianity belief relationship kind of thing intact. Until I started to kind of think more about like my faith and what that actually meant. Like the word faith, what does that even mean? It's believing in something when you don't have all the evidence for it, or you don't know for certain. You know, there's that story about Jesus rebuking Thomas for not believing unless he had that proof of the holes in his hands. And Jesus's words are used as kind of a reinforcement of, you know, faith over evidence. And when I started to really think about, you know, faith and what it actually was, that kind of was the biggest piece for me. I realized that so many other religions believe so many different things on faith. What can you not believe on faith? Is it really a reliable path to truth if it's just a confident kind of belief or an assertion in something that you can't prove? That didn't seem logical or reasonable to me. So after looking at the evidence, I realized that I don't have a good reason for what I believe anymore, and that it was all kind of about that extra step that, yes, we don't have evidence for it, but if you require evidence to believe this, your faith is weak. Once I realized how much of my faith was based on faith, a flip switched in my brain, and I just knew that I didn't want to have to believe things on faith anymore. I wanted to be informed, and I wanted to understand what I was personally believing. that was kind of the moment when I realized that I was an atheist. It was kind of refreshing to know that I didn't have to have an answer or an explanation for everything. We're still finding things out. We don't have to assume or claim to know anything that can't be proven. It's okay to say, I don't know sometimes. And a lot of the time, that's the honest thing to do. And it felt good to kind of use that title finally. Becoming an atheist and really questioning my beliefs has only made me better. And I want to continue to become better and improve myself and the world around me. I think that once you realize how much of religion is based on fear and guilt, it's impossible to go back to. I've been an atheist for almost 3 years now, and this has become kind of my passion now. I would love to talk with more people about this and kind of show people my perspective and help them kind of see the world the way I see it and the way I saw it. That's kind of why I created this channel and why I'm telling you my story. Becoming an atheist has definitely changed my life for the better, and I can't wait to see what I'll learn next and the kind of person that I'll be in the future.